Kate Cassidy was pregnant in high school?
Yes. Wait, your names are Nate and Kate?
Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. Today, we've been talking about Portland radio and its interplay with Portland culture. Joining us now is Oregonian pop culture reporter Kristi Turnquist. Hello, and how are you today?
I'm just fine. Hello, Rick.
I want to ask you before we begin here to tell me if you have any equivalent to the radio stories that we just heard. From a listener perspective, do you remember the first radio show, radio host, radio broadcast that really connected with you?
Well, I'm a Portland native, so I've listened to Portland radio for a long time. And when I was a kid, I used to listen on a crummy little transistor radio. I know it makes
me sound
like, you know, Grandma Moses. But I would listen to this crummy little transistor radio to Kissin' Radio.
Is that while waiting for the ice wagon to come by?
Yeah, drawn by horses.
Excellent.
Yeah.
And what was it about that made such an impact on you?
They played rock and roll, man.
Played all the hip tunes for the kids.
Yeah, you know, top 40, and, you know, how could you not listen?
That is true enough. And it is sort of strange, actually, that more television programs don't take place in the world of radio. There are a few, as we found out, but not as many as the medium would seem to call for in terms of just the raw amount of stories that are there to be told. Before we talk about Life Unexpected, we should discuss the use of Portland as a shooting location and or the setting for television programs. The only one that I come up with was Hello Larry with McLean Stevenson, and I'm one of like three people in the whole world who even know what I'm talking about.
I mean,
right now,
I vaguely remember when that was on. I mean, it was after McLean Stevenson left MASH.
Yeah, he chose poorly.
Yes, he chose poorly. And anyway, yeah, he was the star of the show called Hello Larry, and I had to look on Wikipedia to sort of, you know, stir my memory. And he actually played a radio talk show host who moved from L.A. to Portland.
Really?
And so it obviously wasn't filmed here, but it was set here.
All I know about Hello Larry is that it was purportedly some kind of a spinoff of Different Strokes, because there was this weird crossover episode where, I'm not making this up, where Arnold and Willis came to Portland. And of course, they never showed Portland at all, ever. It was like them standing outside on a balcony with no sky or outdoors visible, and they made some remark about how it's strange to be in a city where you can't see the air. Hilarity ensues.
Hilarity.
Go to commercial.
Gosh, I'm sorry I missed that.
So I came up with Hello Larry and Frasier, and that is
also
widely
about a radio
beyond Portland
host
to the Northwest. I got nothing beyond that.
Well, yeah, I mean, Frasier obviously set in Seattle. I mean, I think, you know, Frasier, among its many virtues, and I really liked the show. It was a terrific show. It did sort of help establish this stereotype of the Northwest, you know, because they were always drinking coffee and drinking fine wines, and you know, that aspect of Northwest life hadn't really become part of the stereotype. I mean, the other stereotype about the Northwest had been, you know, going back to 1968, Here Come the Brides, which was set in Seattle. It was a ripoff of Seven Brides for Seven Brothers. It was about this logging camp in 1870 that imported a bunch of brides. Starred David Soul and then teen idol Bobby Sherman.
Okay, for you kids at home, there once was a show called Starsky and Hutch, and that's before it was an ill-conceived box office failure a couple years ago. David Soul, and it was in a logging camp?
Yeah, set in 1870. So that
nothing says romance like a logging camp with the guy from Starsky and Hutch.
Oh, and I mean, unfortunately, that was sort of the Northwest stereotype, you know, like people cutting down trees and being hardy. And
it's almost hard to believe they don't set more things in this town. There does seem to be a bit of a default setting that if you're creating a television show, especially a comedy for some reason, it's got to be set in New York or maybe Los Angeles.
Yeah.
From an artistic point of view, is there a reason for that you can see, or is it just easier to write what's outside your window if you're some guy in Manhattan?
I think it's both. I mean, I think, you know, obviously the people in show biz who are sort of greenlighting these shows, creating these shows, tend to live in either New York City or Los Angeles. A lot of them happen to grow up there too, not all certainly, but a lot did, and that's kind of what they know. And I also think there's a bit of a stereotype involved there too, in which they can't conceive of people being quick-witted and funny enough to be on a TV sitcom who don't live in those cities. Because if you don't live in those cities, apparently you're out there, you know, cutting down trees.
Because if you're in Burbank, you've got wit.
Exactly.
And whatnot.
Yeah, you're a regular Oscar Wilde.
Exactly. I'm going to start calling myself the Oscar Wilde of Gresham.
You should.
So, you know, you were here when I made that decision. We come back, we will talk a bit about Life Unexpected, which is actually set in Portland, Oregon, though it is filmed elsewhere. explication of that statement and more from Kristi Turnquist, as well as half of Simon and Sam in the morning. They're going to arm wrestle during the break here to see who comes back on to discuss that program. You are watching Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV. Stay right there.